Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss about some Aari Zardozi business tips. Okay, so what worked for me? I'm going to talk about that. So initially, when you want to start a Aari Zardozi, you have to learn the Aari Zardozi. That is very important, first point, okay? You have to learn thoroughly, basic to advanced. So take 1 month to learn the course. You can't complete the course in 10 days, 15 days. You can't do like that, okay? You need minimum 1 month to complete the course. So if you see in Aari Zardozi, there are 30 stitches with thread. Okay, thread works 30 and Zardozi 30. And there are more designs actually. Basically, this 30, 30, 60 is very important stitches. Okay, you have to learn all these 60 stitches. So after learning the stitches, you should know how to apply the stitches in the designs. So I am just going with the technique what I am teaching. Okay, many people will have different techniques. Okay, I am just going with my technique. So after learning the stitches, you have to know how to apply the stitches in the designs. So after completing this, give another 1 month time for practicing. 1 month is completely for learning and 1 month complete for practice. So while practicing itself, start a Instagram page or whatever social media. Okay, how to start a page? So you'll be start posting your pictures. Whatever you have practiced, you have to post the pictures with good photography. Okay, how to post your pictures in the social media wherever you are active. So once you finished your practice, when you are ready to take orders, so you have posted your pictures from long time. So when you start taking your orders, when you are ready, ideally you'll be having some followers. So when you post the ad, they'll be ready to give you the orders. Okay, before taking the orders, what are the things you have to make sure that from your side it is ready? So first, Aari cot. Okay, so when you are taking the orders, you should never go with the Aari strand. Okay, you may not know what quality of the fabric the client has got. He might have got a 320 rupees silk cotton fabric or 150 rupees silk cotton fabric. So you should able to identify the fabric range also, price, by feeling the fabric, because the silk cotton which is low cost will be very thin, the weaves will be visible outside. The silk cotton with higher price will be little thick, the weaves will not be seen outside. But some clients, they used to buy 300 rupees silk cotton fabric and they'll tell to work on that. We can do the work on that also, but you should not fix that fabric on the frame. You have to go with the cot. When you're fixing the fabric on the frame, what happens? The fabric where you have fixed with the frame will get damaged. Okay, sometimes it get cuts in the blouse pattern. But if not, you have to face the client when it got damaged. Okay, so avoid the Aari strand. Only for practicing, only when you are learning, use the Aari strand. After that, invest in a Aari cot. Golden beads, golden sari, and silk threads, 50 color silk threads, crochet needles, and tracing powder, tracing paper, Zardozi, that spring kind of thing will be there, no? Zardozi. So choose everything in gold color. So gold color is one which will go with all colors. Any kind of fabric you can use this gold beads. So invest little in the beginning. So once you are getting orders, slowly buy little, 20 grams, 30 grams, like that. Once you are going for a next level, then you can invest in all types of beads and you can place it in your workplace. Okay, so yes. So when you are ready to take the orders, when the client is going to approach you, you should have some samples. Samples in the sense, not a complete blouse like this. No need to do the complete blouse like this. What I am telling like samples is, I'll show you. So in one complete fabric, do one peacock and keep it, and one mango, okay, and some border designs. So draw a straight line, like rectangle shapes lines with 3 inch, 3 inch, like that, rectangles. In between that rectangle shape, do this border design, like 20 to 25 types of border designs. You have to keep it ready with lamination. All these things should be laminated. So when the client is approaching you, when you are in a startup business place, so you should impress them by your content and your work. Okay, so you have to be very neat in showcasing your work, and you have to be very strong in your content. You have to explain them when you are fixing the budget. Okay, you have to understand the client's design, what they have in their mind. So before going and taking the order, you have to sketch the design. When your client is giving the work, you have to sketch the design. So it's not required, mandatory, that you have to be very good in sketching. Just do a small sketching by writing the name. If they are asking first layer bead, second layer zadi overlapping, just write down, do the rough sketch and show them, this is what I am going to do, like that. So you have to get the confirmation from the client before you start the work. And you have to tell the budget also. You want the low budget, medium budget or high budget. So based on the material what you are going to choose, what is their client requirement, you have to tell them the budget. It is going to be like this. So when they are satisfied, you have to start the work. So before starting the work, you have to explain everything in detail to the client. So client satisfaction is very important. When you are there in the starting stage, when you are starting your RE Zardozi business, what you can do is you can give the bag as complimentary. Okay, the muslin fabric, you know. So meter will be around 60 rupees or 70 rupees. You can make 5 to 6 bags in 1 meter. Okay, so which will fit this blouse. Okay, so you can give that bag as a complimentary. So you can make that bag with Velcro stick and give that bag as a complimentary. So that will also help you to develop your business and to get the clients. They'll get impressed by see the bag. Okay, they don't need to invest in one more airtight bag or something. So they'll keep the blouse safe in your bag itself. Next, you can make a dori. Okay, dori you can tell them as complimentary. So I am telling all these things in the initial stage to develop your business. So when you are going to the next level of business, no need to give anything for free. You can just be strong in your content. You should have confidence and you have to be strong in the content. No need of offers, no need of free. Just be strong in your content and explain what you are going to do and what kind of materials you are going to use. You have to be strong in the content, like you have to explain them. So how long your work is going to stay. It is not going to fade out in few days. I am going to use such kind of products. Like that you have to explain. Okay. So next, pitching, budget, everything I have told. So as I told you in the beginning stage, don't invest lot. Okay. So in my previous video, if you see, I have told to invest 20,000 for sewing course. Because if the business is not going to the next level, means also you can make use of the sewing machine. You can make use of all the products. Like lifelong, it is not going to get waste. It is going to be used for us to stitch a dress. But these kinds of beads, right, it will get fade out. So initially do step by step. Initially invest little, then go. And one more thing, so if you are nearby, if you are in the town, if you are buying the material nearby, it's fine. If you are in the village place, if you are traveling to buy the material, you have to charge that also with your client. Okay, you have to explain them, you have to. Okay, so before going for a budget, how to fix the price, I'll just tell you what I tried to explain in this video. First, you have to learn the course. Next, 1 month for course learning and 1 month for practicing. When you start practicing itself, you have to start your own label and you have to start posting your picture. Slowly, you will get your clients, okay? Third one is samples. You have to make samples, okay, that when you are practicing itself, you can make the samples. And the fourth one is yes, I forgot to mention that you have to be regular in your pictures. Wherever you are there in the social media, you have to post the pictures regularly. And understand the client requirement. You have to understand the client's mind, what they are having in their mind designing. Next one is after understanding the client's requirement, you have to do the rough sketch of that. Discuss about the budget. Budget you have to discuss about. You have to discuss about the budget to them based on the design, what product you are going to use. You have to discuss about the budget. And most important thing is you have to be on time. So if you are sure that you are going to finish the blouse in 2 days, you have to give the word of 2 days. Or else you can take your own time, tell them 5 days before that. After telling 5 days, you can even complete in 3 days. But after telling 3 days, you should not take more than that. Okay. So these kind of things will help you to build the trust in your brand. And complimentary bag, which I have mentioned. Okay. These are the small tips to develop your business. And price fixing. Price fixing on the starting stage or in the develop stage. However, you have to fix it in the way material cost. Okay. So material cost, if it is 500 rupees, you have to write it 500. Okay. So if you are in a village, so somewhere around inside the village, you have to travel to buy the material and come. So you have to include the travel expenses also. Okay. Next, time, how much hour you are taking to complete the blouse. If you are taking like 2 days or 3 days, based on that, per hour you have to rate it. So you have to decide how efficient you are. So if you are in the beginning stage, like you can do only simple designs, you have to fix like per hour 30 rupees like that. If you are well and good in your designs, you can fix per hour 50 or 60 rupees like that. So you have to calculate for 2 hours, how much hours you have spent time, have to calculate like that. And finally, margin. Margin is the one which you are going to get as a profit. Material cost will go for material, travel expenses will go for travel expenses. You are going to get the time, how much you have spent to do the work. And next final is margin. Margin is like you are giving money to your mind. You are going to sit and think what design you are going to do, and you are putting some time to trace the design and work out what we have to put, what products we have to use, what kind of chunkies you have to use, golden beads. So that is the margin you are going to keep. Okay, if it is grand design, you are going to keep a big margin like 800 or something. If it is like small design, you are going to keep the margin as 300. So you have to calculate everything, and that will be the blouse price. So likewise only you have to fix the blouse price when you are going to do the design by yourself. Okay, so material cost and how much hour you are going to take per hour, 30 or 60 you can charge, and finally margin. So margin is like your time to design. You can keep it like that. Based on the design, you can decide the margin. Okay, this is when you are going to design the blouse by yourself. So when you are going to have a karigas, okay, so initial stage you can do the blouse by yourself. Slowly when you are getting more doubts, you have to take the help of others. So the person who does this ari work is called karigas. Karigas, we used to say as karigas. So when you're going for them, people are different. Okay, people, they come from outer place and they ask for a stay, and we used to pay 15,000. Okay, food stay will be ours, and we used to pay 15,000. Some people, they'll come around our place itself, somewhere around our place, and they will ask for per day 1,000 rupees. So 30,000, and some range of people will be 20,000. When they are more experienced, more than 15 years of experience, they'll ask 35,000. So this is the price range. Some boutique persons are there, they used to give a commission for each blouse. Like if they are charging for one blouse 3,500 rupees, they'll give commission like 300 rupees, 400 rupees, and few more people. Each and everyone will have different ideology. Okay, so few more people, what they do is they pay them like hourly charge. Like they will not have the boutique person for full time. They'll call person, if they're having work, they'll come, they'll work for some hours. So they'll pay for a hourly charge, like 1 hour 100 rupees, 200 rupees, like that. So based on the orders, how much you are getting, and based on your budget, based on your investment, you can take the karigas. I have shared all the details, and I'll show you some designs here, design ideas for Adi Zardosi work. First ideas, okay. So this saree is completely silver color, and this is the blouse came along with that. So here you can see we have made completely with silver. So these blouses are done by me, okay. So silver saree. So like this I have done, and I have to show you the pattern blouse. This is called pattern blouse. This is a plain blouse. Okay, so I have just designed like I have drawn the sleeve, and I have decided like I have to give a beads, straight line beads here. So you can see here, like bead stitch beads, and beads waterfall, and beads chain stitch, beads French knot. This is called pattern blouse. Like one line, I have decided one stitch, and I have done this blouse. Okay. So this picture I have taken from Pinterest as reference, and I have made this blouse. And highlighting the blouse. So if the blouse quality, the blouse which comes along with the saree, the blouse quality is not good, okay, we can't do embroidery, but they are asking for embroidery, then you have to suggest them. We can just do the highlights, but not heavy work on the blouse fabric, because the blouse fabric weaves are very thin. So this blouse comes under that case. The weaves are very thin. If I am doing heavy work, what happens? This cross is going right, it will have so much of holes. So I have just highlighted the blouse with the silk thread like this. Okay, the saree is having dark green color, so I have just did the highlights like this. So this is highlighting the blouse. So this type of blouse are called pattern blouses. And remaining blouses are normal blouses like this. Zadi works. So initially I was telling like samples, right? Like this one mango. So like this you have to do one. You have to laminate and keep it for a long time for client reference. So I have shared all the ideas, whatever works for me. Hope it will be useful for you also. Thank you. Bye-bye.